Hi everyone, welcome to JavaTechie. Serverless architecture is scaling more and more popularity in market, and nowadays everyone moved their application pattern to serverless programming. So what do you mean by serverless architecture or programming? Serverless basically mean you just run your code without any server. I mean, we no need to maintain or manage the server. As a developer, we just need to focus how to build our logic. Okay, all right. Let's understand advantages of using this serverless architecture. Zero server management. As we are not going to run our code in any server, so we no need to provisioning or managing the server. Flexible scaling. Based on your incoming request to your application has capability to auto scale. If you want, you can customize it based on the throughput you need. No ideal capacity. You no need to pay for ideal capacity. Only you need to pay for the compute time you will use. Let's say I hosted my application to AWS Lambda. If someone is executing my function, then I need to pay for it. Okay, all right. Now let's understand how AWS Lambda will help us to design a serverless architecture. AWS Lambda is a serverless computing service provided by Amazon to reduce the configuration of server and operating system. AWS Lambda lets you run code without provisioning or managing the server, and also it scales automatically and it will only charge for the time your code is running. This is what the main advantages of using this serverless programming. Only you need to pay if your code is executing, or else you no need to pay single rupees. Okay. Now, where to use? When you want to expose a web endpoint or a stream processor or a task to the cloud without depending on any server or operating system. So if you remember, few months back I uploaded a tutorial on Spring Cloud function. That is the best example to demonstrate this serverless programming. Let me go through the code so that you will get concrete picture about this serverless programming. Also, if anyone not aware about Spring Cloud function, you can check out my tutorial. I will also add the video link in description. Okay, let's go to IntelliJ IDE. So this is the same example which we did in our Spring Cloud function tutorial. I have a class called book with field ID and name, and I have one main class. So if you observe in this main class, I was exposing three endpoint as a functional service. Okay. So if you observe, I didn't specify any URL mapping. So how I can say this is my endpoint? How can I access it? That's what the advantages of using this Spring Cloud function. Using functional interface, simply you can expose your endpoint as a function. So if you observe here, this function, supplier, consumer. These three are the functional interface introduced in Java 8, right? So if you'll go to this function, you will find target and resource, or you can say return, and it contains one method called apply. It will accept the target and it will return whatever the you will specify as a generic here. So that's what we did here. We are just getting the input and we are just trying to reverse it. Okay. Same way, we can expose our service using this functional interface. So what I will do, let me run this application so that I can show you how we can access this endpoint. So same thing already I explained in Spring Cloud function tutorial. On top of the Spring Cloud function, I was going to develop this AWS Lambda concept. Okay, so let me run this first. Yeah, so our application is up on port 8080. If you remember, we don't need any server to run a functional programming, right? Then why in Spring Cloud function we need this server? So for local testing, it added the embedded server even though we didn't add any web dependency. But for local testing, the Spring Cloud function added the embedded Tomcat. But when I will deploy in AWS Lambda, we don't need any server. So we'll see that. First, let's access this endpoint. Okay. So what I will do, I will go to the terminal. Then to access this endpoint, I need to fire a call URL. So I can access this particular endpoint with the help of method name. So this method name will act as a endpoint URL. So I can write something like this: curl hyphen h content type text slash plain localhost 8080 slash reverse. So this reverse is the same my method name. Okay. And if you observe here, we need to pass one input. Then based on that input, I just need to reverse it. Okay. So I will pass some input here called JavaTechie. And if you observe, I was getting the output in reverse order. Similarly, if you go to the second endpoint, the endpoint URL is get book, right? So I can hit the URL, something like this. We don't need to pass any input here. We just change the method name as a URL. Okay, we don't need this D as well. Yeah, we can see the response here, right? So this code is working fine as expected, right? Now what we'll do, we'll create one more Spring Cloud function with real-time scenario. Then we'll deploy that code, or we'll run that code in AWS Lambda as a function. Okay, so let's get started. Let's quickly create a Spring Boot project. Click on project. Next, change the group ID to com.javatechie. And artifact ID, I will specify Spring Boot, AWS Lambda. Then I want to specify same as my project name. And Java version, change it to Java 8. Also change the package name here, com.javatechie.aws.lambda. Now click next. So I will add Lombok dependency. Also I will add AWS core. Okay. Now click next. Finish. Now go to the pom.xml. So let me minimize these things. If you'll go to pom.xml, we didn't add any dependency related to AWS Lambda. Okay. We added only Spring Cloud Starter AWS. Even we don't need this dependency, I believe. Let me remove this and let's add all the required dependency. Okay. So I already copied the dependency which is required. I will add the source code link in video description so you guys can directly reuse it. Okay. So these are the dependency we need. Let me add it. We need the Spring Cloud function adapter AWS. And AWS Lambda Java events and AWS Lambda Java core. Okay. Also, we need to add one more plugin to generate a lightweight jar. Usually, our jar size will be more than 10 MB. And if I have 10 microservices, then it's difficult for me to deploy that code in AWS Lambda. Okay. Because 10 microservices around it will take more than 100 MB. So, we need to downstream the size of our jar. So, that's the reason we need to add one more plugin in Maven. So I will directly copy this plugin section. You can find this plugin in Spring Boot official documentation as well. So let me add this. So I will specify the final name of my jar. I will give something called Spring Boot AWS Lambda. Okay, now save this. There is some error. Okay, I need to add this version. Okay, so let me add the version. Go to the properties file, properties tag. Then we can add the version here. Fine. Now let's go to our src, main, Java. Then let me create few packages. Let's create a package called domain. Then I am not going to create a service class, so I will directly write my logic in the main class. Okay, I just want one domain and also I want one repository. So I'll create one more package called repository. Yeah, so in domain, let me create a class called order. So I will add few fields. ID name, price and quantity, and as I added Lombok dependency, so I can directly add Lombok annotation. Okay, so I'm going to create one repository, but we are not going to connect to any database. So for demo purpose, I will directly create a class and I will hardcode few order object. Okay, so create a class, something called order DAO, I will specify it. And I will annotate this with @repository. So here I will write a method who will return me the list of order object. Okay, list of order. I will something mention like prepared orders or build orders. I will directly return it, and I can directly return this. So I hard code here four order object: 101, 102, 278, 953. And if you observe, the book is repeated here. So I want to write some scenario where based on the order name, I want to fetch list of order object from this database. Means this is just dummy database, we can say, as we hard code the value here, right? So now go to this and we'll create the functional interface or functional programming here. Okay. So first I just want to return all the order object. So first we need to inject the order DAO here. I will inject using AutoAdd. Then to return all the object or all the data from the repository, I can use the supplier interface, right? So public supplier. So let me go to the supplier method. Yeah, it don't have any argument, but it have the return type. So what I will do, I will specify the return type as list of order object, import it. Yeah, so I will specify the name something like orders. Okay, and I can directly return all the order object which is present in my DAO. Fine. So this is what the lambda representation of this particular method, get method, right? So similarly, let me write one more method who will take the input, and based on the input, it will filter from the list and it will return the object. So I will use function. If you go to this function, I have a method called apply, right? Let me copy this so that I can show you the lambda representation of it. It will take the input as string, which will be order name, and it will return me the list of order object. Okay, actually you can do this example by integrating with database, but to save the time for demo purpose, I was just hard coding the value in DAO layer. So what I will mention here, the method name order by name. So we can specify something like this, find order by name. Okay, then I will add this method so that I can show you the lambda representation of it. So we don't want any prefix, just remove it, and we no need to specify the data type. So I can directly specify here input, and that input I will just filter over this list of order object, then I will return it. So let me write something, order DAO dot build orders dot stream, then I want to filter it based on the input name. Means if I will give mobile, then all the order whose name is mobile, it will give me that order object, list of order object. Okay, filter, I will give order, yeah, order dot get name dot equals the input. Okay, then collect as a list and just return it. Fine. So some mistake we did. No. Now let me format it, and we need to annotate this with @bin annotation. Fine. So we just created two function as a endpoint, and we'll add this function in our AWS Lambda. But before that, if you are using Spring Boot, Lambda always search for a request handler class. So we need to create an empty interface extending from Spring Boot request handler. So I will create a class here called I can give some name, order handler, and I will extend it from Spring Boot request handler. And you need to specify the data type of your object. So always we are giving string as a input, and we are expecting list of order as a return type. So I can directly specify object here. Okay, so this interface is empty interface, but this Spring Boot request handler interface we need so that it will helps us to serialize and deserialize object. Okay, that's why we specify the type generic here. Now save this. We don't need to annotate anything here. Fine. Now what we'll do? Let's create a jar of our application. So I'll go to this Maven. I'll go to lifecycle. I can run a jar of it. It will take couple of seconds. Meanwhile, go to our browser. And what I will do, I will go to AWS console. Now let me sign into the console. We'll create a AWS Lambda function. Then in services, you can search Lambda. Then go to this dashboard. And here you will get option to create a function. Okay, just click on this create function and author from scratch. So just click on that, then give your function name. I will give Java Techie function, something like that. And you can choose the version, means the runtime support. I will choose here Java 8. Now create the function. So if you observe, it created a function, right? Now we need to do few configuration here. So if you'll go to this basic setting info, click on this edit. So here you need to provide your request handler class. Okay, so this is what just we created in our Spring Boot, right? So what we'll do, we'll just copy the package and name of the class. So the class name is order handler. I'll just copy the name and the package com.javatechie.aws.lambda. Go to this. I'll remove everything. com.javatechie.aws.lambda.handler name, class name. Okay, and click on this save. Then one more thing, if you observe, I have two function here. One is orders and one is find order by name. So we need to tell to AWS Lambda, if I will specify the function name, then call that particular function. Okay, so for that, what I will do, I will first just copy this function. So go to here. If you will come down in this environment variable, you need to specify add environment variable. You just tell to this AWS Lambda which function you want to execute. Okay, function name, then give the name of your function, orders. Okay, click save. Now you need to deploy your jar file. Go to this action, upload a zip or jar file. Just click on this, click on upload. Then go to the directory. So we have in different folder download, then Java Techie code base. We created this, right? Yeah. Go to this target. And if you remember, we added one the plugin to downstream our jar size. That is why the jar size is 15 KB. But initially when I tried with the lightweight jar, I found some issue. So I will directly add this jar. Okay. Size is 15.4 MB. Click on save. So our code deployed to Lambda. Now what we'll do, we'll just test it. So configure test event and I will give the name called Java Techie function. Okay, don't allow like this. Function test, something like that. For orders, if you will go to the endpoint, for orders we don't need any parameter or any request parameter, right? So for that, I will just remove this because you don't want. I'll just add one empty string. Now click on create. Then just click on this test. If you observe here, executing function, and you can see the result here. Execution result succeed. Now if you will click this, you can see all the order object, right? 101, 2, 278, 953. These are the four object we created. And if you'll come down, you can see the log here. This is the request ID. and if you observe, the build duration is this much millisecond, and the entire your function execution duration is this. Okay, now let's try to access the second function. So for that, what we will do, again we need to change the function name here. Okay, so let me copy the function name. The function name is find order by name. Now go to the browser and change it to the find order by name. Now click on save. Now click on, we need to go to this, and again we need to pass the parameter, right? So if you will go to the method, we are adding one parameter here, correct? And based on that parameter, we are filtering out all the order object. So for that, what we will do, we'll just go to this, and we need to pass the name mobile. So again, I just want to show you here, based on the input name which I will give, I will get the list of order object. So go to the order DAO. If I will give the name book, I should get two order object. If I will give mobile, I will get one object. If I will give this, I will get one object. So I will give this book. Now click on save and test it. Execution result succeed. Now if you will go to this, if you observe here, we are getting two object, right? So let me drag this down. Yeah, we have only two object with the same input parameter, which is book, right? Now if I will retry it, I will get the response quickly. And if you will come down, the build duration 100 millisecond, and the duration it take to execute my particular method 0.83 millisecond. Okay, so if I will access this particular function, then I need to pay for it. Or else if my function is deployed in AWS Lambda, but no one is using it, then you no need to pay for it. That's what the advantages of using this serverless programming. Yeah, so this is how you can play with AWS Lambda. In my next tutorial, I will show you how we can add the trigger and how we can integrate Cloud API Gateway. Okay. That's all about this particular video, guys. Thanks for watching this video. Meet you soon with a new concept.